By the power vested in me by the great Commonwealth of Kentucky, I hereby sentence you to 99 years in a correctional facility.
Addiction!
It's all right here, Your Majesty. This medieval Kentucky law states that if the defendant has a big red butt, and the judge is cute and fuzzy with their long, bushy tail, the judge must serve the entire sentence of 99 years with the convicted defendant.
Preposterous, Mr. Rumpstein.
Rumpstein.
Let me see. Fuzzy tail. 99 years with defendant in correctional facility.
See? I told you so!
It appears you are correct, Mr. Rump. Stein.
Stein!
It is my job to uphold all laws, even patently stupid laws. So, I hereby sentence myself to 99 years to be served with Mr. Baboon in a correctional facility.
Lose something?
Well, I... Say, aren't you the defense attorney that put me here?
No. I'm the warden here! As I recall, there are supposed to be two prisoners in this cell. So where's your cellmate?
I am not that monkey's keeper. I don't know where he went.
You didn't eat him, did you?
Me? Eat baboon?
You savage.
But I...
Eating your cellmate is an infraction. 30 days in the box!
You're in big trouble.
I thought you were in big trouble.
30 days in there? You can't be serious.
Oh, I'm dead serious, Bucko. I'll see you in 30 days! This'll teach you to eat your cellmate.
Well, IR, today's flight will make our 1,000th successful mission.
Oh, Captain, some man in 14D can't get his peanuts open! Oh, Captain, oh, Capitan, all that turbulence has caused all the women to go into third stage labor. Simultaneously!
Flesh?
Ah! Captain Baboon. I hereby place you under arrest, and your first mate shall be placed in charge.
Ha! That's no good. He busy doing important job.
Oh? Where is he?
He down below, waxing the dinghy. I'm first mate Red. I feel all tingly. I'm first mate Red. Just waxing the dinghy.
You get this tub turned around while I go find him. Excuse me, my good man.
Hello. It's me, the first mate!
Can you be helped?
Do you know you are out of uniform?
And your point is?
I... Never mind.
Yoo-hoo, sailor!
Huh?
Oh, 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 you poor wet squirrel. Here, climb up into the dinghy.
Oh, thank you. I thought I was a goner.
No, it's your lucky day, baby! Stupid Weasel! I are too smart for him.
Wait a minute! Hold everything! What kind of bedtime story was that? This is my cartoon. How come Baboon gets all the glory while I end up riding in a dinghy?
Well, I certainly enjoyed the story, Baboon. Did you like the ending? Oh, yes. I liking that ending very much. Oh, well, that settles it then. Good night!
Dr. Van Smelsing.
The famous vampire hunter.
Oh, that's right, girls. Would anyone care to buy a vampire skin rug? Or maybe some vampire jerky? All right, let's cut to the chase. I know you've had vampires in here.
Oh, yeah, they was real nice folk.
Nice folk? Nice folk! Vampires are evil, blood-sucking fiends. The only good vampire is a dead vampire. And when I catch these two, I'll drive stakes through their hearts. Ta-ta.
Gosh, I sure am glad that vampire hunter never found you.
What vampire hunter?
This vampire hunter! Now I'm gonna put these stakes through your hearts!
But my good man, these are flank steaks.
So, sue me. I've got it!
Victory is mine.
You, sir, are a cruel, hateful man.
Vampires are people, too.
Sometimes you must walk a mile in another man's moccasins before you truly understand him.
Were you talking to me?
Hey! Who are you, being? I am your wife, you ungrateful villain!
Right.
Yes, your wife! You don't remember me! Oh, I slave away in front of the TV all day long while you sit and do nothing at work!
I am sorry. Waiting a minute. Oh, you're not happy, Ray. Crazy lady, keeping out of all your strata.
You know, I always cry at weddings. It's my sensitive side showing. Oh, throw the bouquet!
Throw the bouquet!
Glory! I guess I'm the next to get married.
Hey! This is a phony diploma. You crossed out the otic in psychotic and wrote in iatrist.
You meaning pantsless doctor are not psychiatrist?
I'm afraid not, old friend. He's just pantsless.
It says I am a fraud right in my name.
I may be a fraud,
but so is my dad, Sigmund Fraud Sr. In fact, we're all frauds. My whole family.
There. Maybe we can help.
It all started when I was about 9. I was just a boy. I didn't know pants were required at school.
Who would have guessed?
You know, pal, he may be insane and a fraud, but he still needs our compassion.
And then Grandmama wouldn't let me play on the swings.
And the twins made me wear the dress.
I could be wrong about that compassion part.
A job and a prom dress.